Welcome back to Market 180, the fastest 180 seconds in the market. I'll tell you everything you need to know to stay up to date and what I think. Yesterday, Apple revealed some major hardware and software in its new showcase. This included the Apple Watch Series 6 and updated iPad Air. Perhaps most interestingly, though, was their launch of Apple Fitness Plus for $9.99 a month, which will feature online workout videos. Users can work out from home with as little as a couple dumbbells. I think this is big and will sting gyms that are already hurting big time. Apple is looking to bundle many of their services together with Apple One, which will keep their users in the Apple ecosystem and bring in a ton of monthly revenue. Snowflake IPO'd today. It provides cloud-based data management for companies. Berkshire Hathaway and Salesforce are two big names that have both invested $250 million into it. It's the most valuable software startup to ever go public. In its most recent fiscal year, revenue grew 174% annually to $265 million. However, the company is currently not profitable and is losing money. Snowflake is set to IPO around the $190 range, up more than 60% from its original IPO price of $120. This gives it an insane valuation, and it will be competing against the likes of Microsoft and Amazon. These types of IPOs usually do not end well, and I will be staying away. Yesterday, Chamath Palihapitiya took Opendoor public via SPAC. Opendoor makes cash offers on homes. Chamath believes it can hit $10 billion in revenue by 2023 and keep growing. He also said that it feels to him a lot like Bitcoin in 2012, Amazon 2015, Tesla in 2016, and Virgin Galactic last year. I'm a big fan of Chamath. He's always on the ball, and this company is definitely something that I'm interested in looking into further. Federal Open Market Committee's September Monetary Policy Statement, wow, that was a mouthful, is set to be released today at 2 p.m. Following, Fed Chair Jerome Powell is also set to speak on monetary policy, the economy, and the impact of low rates, as well as the effects of the ongoing pandemic. On September 10, Hindenburg Research released a bombshell report accusing Nikola Corporation of some major deception. They made many claims that Nikola and Trevor Milton, Nikola's CEO, have essentially operated under smoke and mirrors to deceive the public and major investors. The entire company is made out to be an elaborate ruse with bold claims about technology and working models that never come to fruition. Hindenburg does have a short position in Nikola, meaning they profit from Nikola doing poorly. However, Nikola's response to Hindenburg's bombshell accusations were less than reassuring. The report sent Nikola shares plummeting. Last but certainly not least, one big thing to look forward to is Tesla Battery Day. It will be September 22nd, next Tuesday at 1:30 p.m. Pacific Time. Cannot wait. It's going to be epic. There are lots of rumors about some of the things they could possibly be revealing, including a 2 million mile battery, but we'll just have to wait and see. Let me know in the comments below what you think of the companies I discussed and if you're buying Snowflake or Opendoor. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to like and subscribe. This is Vinny from the Investment Club, and I'll see you next time.